thoughts on this? Because protests seem to be popping up more and more. And, you know, let's take a minute just to remember where we were a year ago. A year ago, there was massive protests in Hong Kong about the anti-communism movement there. There were massive protests across Europe for the Yellow Vests and the anti-corporocracy movement against those. And then they shut everything down for a few months, for about 6 months. And now we're starting to see some of these movements popping back up again. I don't know, does anybody predict that perhaps this could be the fall of protests? Or do you think we're all going to get scared back into another cyclical lockdown? Just your opinion. I'm just curious what you all think might happen.
I've heard more lockdowns on the way. Hard lockdowns. Neil Kashkari of the Fed was actually saying that we need a hard lockdown to defeat the virus now.
Yeah. I wouldn't be surprised if cyclical lockdown is the new normal.
So much for flattening the curve.
Yeah, flattening the curve doesn't matter anymore.
Bless up, brothers and sisters. How you doing on the gift that is today, eh? It is the 25th of August, and you're probably wondering, fuck, Tilly, where you been, brother? Where you been? Well, as you know from the only video I dropped this month, I was gifted for my 11th wedding anniversary, as well as my upcoming 53rd birthday, a 2016 Ducati Scrambler Flat Track Pro. My amazing better half, she actually helped me facilitate the purchase of this. So yes, kudos to her and my dearest friends who also were part and parcel of that. So yeah, August has been a good month, but in all truthfulness, it's also been a bad month. Like I say, you give thanks for the gift of the day, good or bad. So a lot of the stuff that's been bad has to do with my overall mental unwellness. Being the crazy motherfucker that I am, I pick up on vibrations, I pick up on frequencies, I just like I'm in a big antenna for the human psyche, so to speak. And as this fucking plant, as this planet gets more cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs, I am fucking vibing hard off of that nonsense. There's some crazy shit going on out there. Obviously, the mainstream media is skewing things. You know, if you're chirping about the official narrative of Black Lives Matter or Antifa, or, you know, save the planet by fucking putting a face diaper on, or fucking stay at home and social distance. There is so much nonsense going on this fucking planet right now that we as a species, we're like ping pong, man. We're like bing, 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 back and forth from one thing to another. So again, the official narrative is we have this worldwide pandemic that is fucking killing people. They're dropping like flies. Obviously, we know that the number of cases is going up while morbidity is going down. That's kind of weird, but then again, they're pretty good at skewing numbers, so I don't believe them for a fucking second. But we do know that the masking is something that's becoming a mandatory thing. Hey, you want to get food? Put on a mask. You want access to your money? Put on a mask. What's next? What's next, eh? Well, they made everyone do forceful confinement, basically house arrest. Not too many chirped about that. That wasn't good for us as a species. It wasn't good for our herd immunity. That was to flatten the curve because, of course, you know, by segregating ourselves from one another, we stopped the spread of this fucking deadly disease. What happened there? Now, second waves of lockdown are rolling through. Europe's having lots of fun. North America's doing its thing. Some places have curfews. I mentioned Australia once upon a time, several months back. 26 million people, give or take. And yeah, they're their death rate was extremely high. It was disgusting. Like fucking kangaroos were dropping like flies, and those people down under are just fucked. But anyways, in all seriousness, 26 plus million people, well south of 10,000 dead from COVID or the flu or being elderly and getting sick and dying because of comorbidity, other health issues. But I digress. Got myself up a little bit of a screen here that says that Melbourne is falling apart. So I'll read this to you a bit. I don't even know where to begin, but I think by now, if you're reading this, you know about the draconian measures currently enforced in Victoria, Australia, particularly Melbourne. What's worse is that the tone around here is generally apathetic or support for these measures, particularly on the hard left, where protesting to dismantle cops mere months ago as part of BLM, it's just pure cognitive dissonance. Thankfully, I don't live in Melbourne. I moved away to regional Victoria just in time in 2018, but many of my friends are still there. And here are some of the measures that are enforced and the stories that I've heard from Melbourne and Victoria. There's a strict curfew between 8 p.m. and 5 a.m. Talks about some people getting fined. One guy got a fine for $1,652 for stopping to get a burger on his way home. Mandatory masks in all of Victoria. Even where this individual lives 90 minutes from Melbourne, in a town where the nearest COVID case is 40 minutes away, and that was months ago, no reported COVID death within the 150-kilometer radius of where this person lives, but they're still made to feel they need to wear a mask and avoid all human contact. No travel except for essential activities. There's army deployed at stops outside of Melbourne to prevent anyone from getting in or out. Heavy police presence and army presence on foot, on the roads, and in the skies because they're handing out fines. They're stopping people and questioning them. The police in these cities can enter your home without a warrant, and there are reports of police breaking car windows to force people to hand over details. Now, I don't know if this is true or not. I'm not in Melbourne. But there is a Facebook group. There's warning on YouTube and Google regarding new censorship legislations. Talk about the annual suicide rate that has been surpassed already there. Most of these suicides are occurring in people under 44. There is a Facebook group, as I mentioned, it's called Millions Rise for Australia, and it's flooded with real-world stories. So I'm not going to go on and beat that dead horse, because this is a sign of things to come. This is what's going to happen here, there, and everywhere. And the total acquiescence of society to this mandate, to this whole narrative and dichotomy, this is what's caused me a lot of mental stress for the past month. Normally I'm putting out 5 or 6 videos a month. I have footage. I've got some drone footage of my dear friends training. I've got them completing the 21-minute sledge challenge again and you know, improving on their numbers. But the creative juices that flow within me, they've been rather stagnant for most of August. I have spent some time, you know, for the break-in period of DuckDuckGo. He's a search engine. That's my Ducati. Some time with him, modding him to make him personalized, as well as putting in some serious consideration into leaving Zombieland. So, Zombieland Facebook. For those of you that don't know, I did shoot a clip that I was going to use as a standalone video explaining why I was leaving Facebook, but I won't use that. I'm just going to explain it to you in this short bit here. I originally joined Facebook in 2007. Within 16 months, I knew that Facebook was a funded subsidiary of a company called InQtel. And that just happened to be a subsidiary of a little alphabet agency called the CIA. So I knew what it was, and I was cognizant of what was going on, and again, because of where my headspace is a lot of the time, and some of the things I look into over the decades, knowing that everything's kind of bullshit, I knew about the data mining, I knew about the fusion centers, I knew about all of this bullshit, but I didn't really care because I was online and I was social networking with people and yeehaw. So as me, as Buddha Sadhu Gaines, I was on Facebook from 07 to 2011. Then I left. I left because I was sick of the continuing improvements to Facebook, the changes, and the general apathy of everyone on Zombieland, hence why I call it Zombieland. There's a lot of, you know, brain dead motherfuckers in the world, and a lot of them spend a lot of time on social media. And hopefully I don't quantify myself as falling into that category, but it's neither here nor there. So I left Facebook and I was gone for almost 5 years. Came back as Chili Boo in 2015 after I was released from prison. Paid my debt to society, came back, decided to have an online persona that was specifically geared towards cannabis lifestyle. So with that, several things grew out of that, and that was cool. So, you know, chug along, got my friends, got my pages, got my businesses. But again, I know full well what's going on. You know, I am feeding into the system. I am part of the very problem in which I fucking protest against. So with the last month being like it is, and the, you know, the apathy that society has expressed, you know, I know there's a lot of us out there that really fucking know what's going on, but the reality is, what are we doing about it? You know, chirping online, some meme shit. Who's got the parts? Who's got the jam when push comes to shove, right? Who really does? I know from my own personal history, and I can only speak of that because, right, it's me. I've walked a mile or two in my shoes, so I know what's what. I know that I have convictions. I know what I stand for and what I believe in, and I try to stand by that. So if we were to get fucking slapped back to the Stone Age right about now, I'd be okay with that for the simple fact that it would do this planet a hell of a lot of good. We as a species, as I've opined many, many times over the last several years on here, on my YouTubes, wherever, that we've become fucking a bunch of comfort bunnies. We've lost basic survival skills. And at a time when we're going to need them more than ever, we're going to be fucked. And people are going to be lining up with their hand out, wanting fucking Big Brother or GovCorp or whomever to take care of them. So I'm not one of those fucking individuals. But I digress. I just wanted to express to you how I was feeling, what was going on, the fact that it has been a good month. It has been a bad month. Our species, think about 2020. 2020 in hindsight, there you go. But think about our species. This fucking year in history, nothing has ever changed us so dramatically unless it was a cataclysmic event, and a true cataclysmic event. You think of the folks that were having a casual day hanging out on, you know, in Pompeii one day, and Vesuvius fucking blows her load and just fucking, you know, the whole scope of what the universe is for that fucking part of the world changed dramatically. But here we are on a global level due to the Wu flu. Yeah, things have been blown out of proportion. People have been agitated, you know, they've been shaken, stirred, turned upside down, just totally discombobulated nonstop for almost 9 months straight. Made a video back in March called Coincidence. That was a breakdown of a Truth Stream Media video that they put out at the beginning of March that basically outlined the next 18 months. Bang fucking on. Bang on, man. So, what do we do at this point in time? Well, I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. I'm dropping a video for you guys. That's what I'm doing. There is a parody video that's going to be on here. You saw a little clip at the beginning. As well as, you see those fuckers in Germany, man, standing up protesting? Where's the jam in North America? There is none. So the video at the end of this is a parody video. And if you were to put this video on YouTube or on Facebook, it gets fucking pulled automatically. If you are to put this back on the Facebook zombie lands, they put you in Facebook jail for 24 hours. After that, I don't know what happens, but I'm not about to go there. I'm just not about to go there because there's fucking no need for me to go there. I'm sharing this with you. You can do what you want, but what I want you to do is keep taking care of yourselves. Keep fighting the good fight. Love is the drug that I'm thinking of, and planet needs a lot more of it. So I'm not trying to be negative, but put out some positivity, put out some kindness, and pay it forward when you can. Thanks for joining me for this obscure video. Peace, love, and blessings from the farm.
You really don't need to cover your face with a diaper all the freaking time. Say, wear a mask if you want to. You can wear it when you drive. You can act like your mask will save the whole world, leaving common sense behind. Mask! But the virus will survive. You say, wear a mask, Rona is out of control. Wear a mask, doing it for the lows. Wear a mask, showing everyone you comply. Wear a mask, everybody's wearing a mask. Your safety mask, you need a safety mask. Oh, safety mask. Get a safety mask.